In today's class, we are going to discuss about classification of real-time scheduling, right? So, in real-time scheduling, different scheduling approaches are pointed out. And in order to understand these approaches, we would like to, you know, only satisfactorily design the real-time system, but also understand the feature of real-time system, what are the basic features of real-time systems are. So, in order to understand that, I'm going to draw a hierarchy of it. Now, real-time scheduling, right? So I'm drawing the hierarchy of real-time scheduling. It can be categorized into two parts. What are the two parts? Soft and hard, right? So there you can actually broadly divide this real-time scheduling into two parts, that is soft and hard time scheduling. Now, hard time scheduling can further be divided into two parts. What are those two parts? Static and dynamic, right? Now, static can also be further, you know, static can be offline, right? And dynamic is online. So, static dynamic, static real-time scheduling is offline scheduling, whereas dynamic real-time scheduling is online scheduling. Now, online scheduling can also be further subdivided into two parts. What are those two parts? It's preemptive. Preemptive, and second one is non-preemptive, right? Similarly, you can also divide this offline scheduling into two parts. What are those two parts? Same, preemptive and non-preemptive, right? So what we have done here is we have broadly classified the real-time scheduling into two parts, that is soft real-time scheduling, hard real-time scheduling. And this hard real-time scheduling can be further subdivided into static and dynamic. When we are talking about the static, that means we are talking offline. And when we are talking about the dynamic, that means we are talking about online scheduling, right? And further, these offline and online scheduling can be divided into two parts. What are those two parts? That is preemptive and non-preemptive. Just like offline scheduling, online scheduling can also be subdivided into preemptive and non-preemptive. So this is the hierarchy of real-time scheduling. This hierarchy is clear to you, students? Now we are going to understand there are different type of real-time scheduling algorithm based on the features of the task that may be static or dynamic. So what we are going to understand, what are the different real-time scheduling algorithm and the features of real-time tasks that may be static or dynamic. Now we are going to understand the most common real-time scheduling approaches, right? So now we are going to take the most common real-time scheduling algorithm, right? Scheduling algorithm. Now, if we have to understand the most real-time scheduling algorithm, then it can broadly be classified or it can broadly be divided into three types of algorithm. What are those three types of algorithm? They are as follow. First is clock-driven approach. What is first? Clock-driven approach. Second one is weighted round robin. Right? We have discussed the weighted round robin. Weighted round robin. And third one is, which one is third? It is priority driven approach, right?